What is good, guys? We're here with Extra Shine versus CL Ulti. Round 4 winners bracket. We see a top lane lead versus most likely defensive Lando. He's gonna switch into Majorna. Psychic does nothing. I assume that's a solve as Majorna, and I think that's a scarf later from Extra side. Looking at the teams, I'm thinking that scarf Terrakion on CL side. Why the fuck did he go hard into Medicham on a Majorna? That was a no play. What? Did he predict Ice Beam? Did he predict Volt Switch? Like, you had a Toxapex and you had your own... Like, they had a Pex and like, what? He's using Pex HO. I'm really surprised that the elf team is looking more offensive than Extras. So if he has Ice Beam, he can go for it here. Even though he's at minus 1, it will still do a fuck ton to this Lando. I think Extras is just gonna go for Rocks here. But yeah, if CL doesn't want to risk Extra going for Quake, he can also just go on his own Lando and play it safe. He goes hard on the Greninja, so he expected the rocks, he gets the play correct. Looking at CL's team, we know it's AV Majorna, so like he has Psychic Spam and then AV Majorna to check opposing Psychic types. Defensive Lando, I assume, because he's weak to Zygarde, and Scarf to Rack, he's weak to Volk otherwise. He gets up Spikes, so we know it's Battle Bond Greninja. Unless he's running the Rare Torrent set, but I'm pretty sure it's Battle Bond. Pex gets up a T-Spike, which is gonna help Extra a bit versus the Lele, the Karakion, and the Greninja. Zam after Mega Evolves also takes poison damage, but it has Magic Guard before. So yeah, CL is gonna, I assume, get up his last layer here. Extra can potentially, like, Toxic this if he has double Toxic plus Toxic Spike, Toxapex. That's, like, a set sometimes, but he's most likely Haze, Toxic Spikes, recovers Scald. So he's gonna switch into Landorus. This is a bit risky because he doesn't know confirmed if this Greninja is choice. This could also be like some Z-move Greninja. So if I'm Extra here, I would go back into Toxapex to scout. Like, if this Greninja is choice, CL would be forced into his own Lando, and Extra could go for HP IC because everything else gets bopped by Earthquake. That would be really nice for Extra, but it's just not worth risking. Greninja being like Z-move and staying in and getting popped as he does scout for it, and there's the Z-move. So yeah, nice play by Extra for sure. This pack seems to be pretty spadef because I remember earlier Greninja went for Hydro Vortex and Occurrence Mist was Black Oblivion series, and I did less, pretty sure I did like I did 35 and now only 27. So this pack is more spadef for sure. Yeah, Extra can just go for recover. I expect CL to go into one of his psychic types or into Landorus. Probably one of his psychic types, because since the Lando is defensive, Earthquake doesn't even do that much to Pex, and the psychic types can threaten the Pex more. Alakazam would be a fine play here because you don't take rocks and Toxic Spikes damage because you have Magic Guard before you Mega Evolve, but Lele works as well here because like Lele threatens the Pex more with like the wow, I can oak you like type of thing, and Extra doesn't have good switch-ins at all. Like, looking at Extra's team, if a Psychic comes out, Cortana is dog shit spadef, and if this is Specs Lele, Cortana would get blown away, especially with Hazards up. His own Majorna is most likely offensive, cannot switch in well. So I don't know what Extra is gonna do here. Is he gonna sack his Specs, or like... Because if this is like Specs and he goes on his own Majorna, he might just get 2-hit KO'd or like blown away. I mean, I'm thinking this is either Specs or like Twisted Spoon, something like that. We've already seen that Greninja was Z-move, and I think in the Terrakion is Scarf. So this shouldn't be Scarf, should definitely be some sort of damage boosting item. He does get a crit, we don't know if it matters. We just know the Pex was more spadef, so it might not have mattered. If he was Twisted Spoon or Specs, I think that didn't matter. I know Pex is bulky as fuck, but it's still super effective. Step Psychic Terrain boosted, and potentially even with a damage boosting item. We obviously don't know that. If Extra could live a non-damage boosting item hit Psyshock from Lele, then it sucks for him that he got crit because now he doesn't know if it's Specs or not in that sense. But yeah, Cortana can threaten this Lele out, so he's still fine here. Like, I don't think it matters too much in the long run. Like, Pex, what would Pex have done? It would have gone for Scald and done some chip damage to Lele. Like, I don't think that would have made a huge difference at all. Like, he could have either gotten another T-Spike, or he could have gone for Scald. Like, if he went for Recover, it wouldn't have changed much. He would have gotten some more chip on Lele, but Lele dies to Cortana. I mean, it's 4-star anyway. Like, yeah, he dies to Leaf Blade. We do see it's Timid Cortana, interesting. Not a big fan of that set. You have to run, like, 9 in attack IVs and sets to have more speed than attack. He goes into the Landorus here. A good play for Sale here would be to go for Hidden Power Ice, because Hidden Power Ice 2-hit KOs Kartana. Earthquake also 2-hit KOs, but Hidden Power Ice also hits the Landorus that Extra might go to. If Spikes weren't up, Extra could predict Sale to go for Hidden Power Ice and go into his Tapu Lele, but since Spikes are up, he would take still too much damage, so Extra is like really tempted to go into his Lander here. He could also just go for SD and then potentially Z-move something with his Kartana just to weaken this Landorus a lot. Since he's timid, I don't think a plus one Z-move will kill. Maybe a plus one Leaf by Z-move would kill like a Bloom Doom if he's that set. But usually I see all-out pummeling on this timid Kartana. Like, I haven't seen timid Kartana often, so like I really don't know what they run most of the time. But I haven't seen Bloom Doom Kartana often overall, like in general. So I don't think he's that set. Goes into Landorus, and CL does make the fire play of going for Hidden Power Ice. Nice damage. So this depends on now on how much speed CL is running on his Lando. If he's running like a good amount of speed, he might be confident here and he can stay in and pop Extra's Lando. But yeah, if he doesn't run much speed, he can go into his Alakazam or like his Terrakion, something like that. Depends on if the Terrakion can kill the Lando from 46. I actually think it cannot kill the Landorus. Because the... Yeah, it's a defensive Lando, and the Terrakion is most likely like Scar if it doesn't have a damage boosting item. So I'm pretty sure Lando will be able to take a Stone Edge unless it gets crit. We've already seen Greninja was Z-move, so Terrakion can't be Z-move. He goes hard Terrak. I feel like Zem would have been fine as well, because like Hidden Power Ice is pretty obvious there, and Zem doesn't take any hazard damage and can then fire off a Psychic. But this works as well. I guess he's just gonna sack the Terrak, because I don't think Stone Edge kills, and afterwards, he kind of gets a kill with his Greninja. He can try to get his Ash form. And if you get... even if Extra's Kartana like gets a speed boost, if CL, like, if there's no Psychic Terrain up, or if like CL can get rid of the Lele, meaning that Psychic Terrain would be gone completely, then he can still revenge Extra's Kartana, even if it gets a speed boost. After Spikes is super low, so he can easily revenge it with Water Shrieking as well. If, like... CL is gonna lose his speed control into Rag here, like, so his LLS speed control is basically Water Shrieking from Greninja. But Scarf Katana is also pretty weak, so like I don't think it's gonna be sweeping CL, let's be honest. I don't even know why I'm talking as if that mon is like Katana is strong, but like its base moves are not that strong. So if you run Timid Nature on top of the base moves being kinda weak, you don't do that much damage, right? And, like, you have to SD up before you like become strong, basically. So I'm trying to say here. So you can go with Greninja here. Extra should never go hard into Midjourney. I think he's probably just gonna sack this. But I would be tempted to go for Hydro Pump if I was CL, just for in case he goes into Midjourney. But it's probably not worth it to risk the miss there. He just goes for Dark Pulse, he gets his Ash form. And Extra is gonna go to his is forced to go in his Scarf Tapu Lele here. I don't know if Midjourney would live as a Hydro Pump after Spikes, but it will definitely take a lot. So the Lele comes out, takes Spikes, and yeah, CL can save this Greninja and switch into his Assault vs Midjourney here, and it's not like Extra Shun can double or anything, because there's like three layers of Spikes on his side, and he doesn't have a good double switch that punishes CL Midjourney, so like, there's like no point in doubling. He's probably forced to go for Moonblast. He's just gonna click that, I'm pretty sure. This Gren is kind of a threat for sure. There's the Midjourney, takes some rocks damage. Moonblast does absolutely nothing, but he gets a special attack drop. So I'm wondering if this is Flash Cannon or Iron Head. Yeah, some people think Iron Head is an unset on Midjourney, but it's pretty cool. For opposing Assault vs Midjourney, opposing Combat Midjourney, and for a Combat Clefable. And whatchamacallit. If he has Flash Cannon instead of Iron Head, then the special attack drops sucks, because like CL cannot really afford to go for Volt Switch in case Extra stays in here. He's probably not gonna stay in, but if he stays in and you go for Volt Switch here, like what are you gonna go to? Like all your other mons kinda get fucked by Scarf Lele. So like I don't think he's gonna Volt Switch. He should just attack what's in front of him here, because even if Extra switches Heathers up, like I said, he switches. Kartana actually took that better than I expected, but that's all. Because of the special attack drop. Forgot about the special attack drop for a second. Yeah, I don't think Kartana can kill the Midjourney from this range, especially because it's timid. Even all-up pummeling probably won't kill, but CL wants this Midjourney healthy. It's really useful to help him with the Scarf Tapu Lele and with the opposing Midjourney. So I assume CL is gonna switch either into Landorus or potentially he's gonna sack off his Alakazam. And Extra might go for SD here expecting the Landorus, or he might just go for Sacred Sword and try to get damage on Mijona, or if he predicts the Alakazam he could go for Leaf Blade. Let's think this through. Yeah, I mean, since the Katana is timid, even if CL's Alakazam dies, if it comes out here, he doesn't get an attack boost, so this is completely fine for CL, because he can then go into Lando after and click off quick. And he doesn't need Alakazam to win. His own Mijona is going to put in a lot of work after Katana goes down, whereas the last 2 months. So yeah, I think going into Zam is a fine play. I mean, I don't think it matters too much what CL sacks here, but he should not sack this Mijona, because the Mijona is fantastic against the Lele and the opposing Mijona, like I said. So he should just switch into something, but I think he's gonna sack the Zammer. And if Extra goes for Leaf Blade or SD, not Leaf Blade, if he goes for like SD or Sacred Sword, then going into Alakazam works out really well for CL. He makes the Alakazam play. I think it was just, he just wanted to sack this, but it worked out really nice for him, because he went for Sacred Sword, so Extra just wanted to get chip on the on the Mijona for his other two members that are that get annoyed by Mijona. So like Extra's play makes sense, but I feel like Extra played too safe. At this point, the game was pretty much over in CL's favor anyway, but Extra kind of had to bank on like CL staying in there, so I understand why he went for Sacred Sword. He just psychics blows this away, because I'm obviously faster. Gets a beast boost, wow. But yeah, he's gonna go Scarf Lele here. Because if he goes Mijona, he probably gets blown away by psychic terrain, boosted psychic, and plus one special attack from Mega Alakazam. Does Mega Alakazam have like 165 base special attack? Dude, Trace is such a cool ability. One of the like fire, like best abilities you can trace with Trace is like beast boost, and Protein is also fire. Sheer Force can also be amazing. But yeah, I assume he's gonna go Scarf Lady, click Moonblast, and CL can afford to sack this. Or he can, yeah, I think yeah, CL can sack this, and then he can go to his own Mijona and click Flash Can. And I think he just wins the game. Because his own Mijona is gonna kill the Lily. After that, he's gonna weaken the Mijona from Extra, and then if that's not enough, he still has Water Shuriken from Greninja, even if CL gets up a Shift Gear. And yeah, CL should have this game in the back. He goes into Mijona. Doesn't this die to psychic and psychic terrain plus one special attack? Hello? Watch this. We crit. I don't know if that mattered. I assume it was no bulk invested in Mijona, so it might not have mattered. But yeah, even if that mattered, the game was over anyway. CL takes game one. I will be back with game two in a bit, and like 1 or 2 hours after this. Stay tuned for that. And yeah, I'm really surprised CL pulled out the offense again. He did that versus Blunder, I think, yeah, as well in game one. And now he did it again. Like, usually you expect him to bring like fatter teams. But yeah, stay tuned for more content. And yeah, peace out. That was a dude, I always fuck up my outros. Like, I'm the god at fucking up my outros. Peace out, friends.